Good morning. Welcome back to Rising and welcome to your talk, your truth, and your tea. Some old allegations against the man known as the King of Pop have come back up.
How we used to talk, no, we'd stay on the phone at night till dawn. Do you remember?
Okay, the molestation allegations against Michael Jackson from Wade Robson will now go to trial. Robson is a choreographer and claims the abuse happened when he was a kid at Jackson's Neverland Ranch. Now, during Jackson's 2005 child molestation trial, Robson testified that, yeah, he slept in the same bed as Jackson, but nothing ever happened. Then, 2013 comes along, he changes his story and claims he was manipulated and brainwashed. Robson is suing MJJ Productions. Well, there's something messy, very messy, going on between Cardi B and husband Offset. Oh, Offset posted a tweet claiming Cardi was a cheater, pumpkin eater, and stepped out on him. Now, that IG post has been deleted, but not before Cardi B could respond on Twitter with a video of her singing Keisha Cole's song, I Should Have Cheated. And Cardi says Offset is just accusing her of doing the dirt that he's been doing all along. We'll have to see if the couple can come back to their happy place. No comment from their representatives. And, you know, remember Cardi B and Offset have two children together, Culture and Waveset. Well, the drama continues for Kim Zolciak and soon-to-be ex-husband Kroy Biermann. According to TMZ, another 911 call was made by Zolciak. Reports say Kroy accused a friend of Kim's of trying to kidnap their son. Now, Kim says she had given the friend permission to take the son on a play date. Kroy says he may have overreacted, and it's just all a case of miscommunication. This is getting cray-cray.
This is the best day ever.
It is the best day ever. So is yesterday, and so is tomorrow, and every day from now until forever.
Yes! All right, the stars of the new live animation film, Barbie, not quite on the same page. Margot Robbie, who plays the plastic blonde icon, was pretty in pain during a photo call over the weekend, but the cast obviously didn't get the memo. They were wearing some boring beige ensembles. The different fashion choices made fans take notice, and not in a very good way. One pointed out that it should be against the law to wear anything but pink to a Barbie event. Okay, former NBA star Dennis Rodman gets a little leggy while he was out supporting Houston's Pride Parade. Rodman, who is 62, wore a short plaid skirt for the event. It kind of reminds you of the little number that Britney Spears wore in her Hit Me Baby One More Time video. Hers was red, I think this is green. Of course, he was criticized for the outfit, but he clapped back saying, "Love will always win. Happy Pride." Angela Bassett may not have gotten the gold at this year's Academy Awards, but she's still going to walk away with a new man in her life. The actress will receive an honorary Oscar. The award will be given out at this year's Governor's Award ceremony. Now, remember, she was nominated for her role in Wakanda Forever this year, and then back in 1993 for her powerful, powerful portrayal of Tina Turner in the movie What's Love Got to Do with It. To receive the honorary Oscar, nominees must have made an exceptional contribution to the film industry. Congratulations, Miss Bassett.
What do you think about that? Do you think it's one thing to be recognized by the Academy, or is it another to actually win one?
Yeah, I think it's kind of lame to have one bestowed on you because, you know, that's a ceremonial thing that they do. I think it would have felt better to her to have won. Because remember her reaction?
Yeah.
When Jamie
exactly.
Lee Curtis?
Yeah.
I think she was really hurt by that. Mm-hmm. But this is good. This is going to look great on her trophy shelf.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And she has had a great career. So mm-hmm. there's no doubting that at all.
Yeah. Yeah. So before we toss it over to Nicole, I have a viewer shout out.
Love it.
So
all right.
I did a little shopping yesterday. And yes, and made a new friend. Her name is
Joan, I think. Janet Dial.
She tapped me. She tapped me on my shoulder, and I turned around and she said, "I love watching you every day. I love everyone on the show." And I said, "Thanks, thanks for watching." And we decided to take a selfie, and I told her I would say hello this morning. So, hello, Janet Dial.
Oh, Janet! How cute are you guys? Look at this. Did you guys find anything good out there?
I did.
Nice.
I found these.
Oh my gosh!
I'll
check
out those New Balances.
Yeah,
those are fancy.
Yeah, I'm
sure
about those. Yeah, those look nice.
So I got these, and I got out of there.
Love meeting people.
In and out. But hey, at least you met a new friend along the way.
And I made a new friend along the way. I sure did.
Love that. Well, it is 8:36 right now. Chief Meteorologist Nicole Madden in the house to take a look at that weather.